Okay, so this thing cut me off. This is part two. I thought it was gonna be 50 minutes. Now it's not even allowing me 50 minutes. Anyway, continue. Okay. Cash-strapped African countries face pain from foreign interest obligations. Foreign investors who plied African countries with huge loans despite obvious difficulties for repayment got some bad news recently. The government of Zambia announced it missed a November 13 deadline to repay $42.5 million in interest. This is only interest in to euro bond holders. So these are dollars, and then these are, I don't understand why, the euro bond holders, after the investors rejected a 6-month delay sought by Zambia to pay up. This could set a precedent. Lenders fear. I'm sorry. Zambia has been struggling to come up with money at a time where the risk of COVID, whatever, infection is high, and prices for their commodities, especially oil, are low. And who made those prices so damn low? Should indebted countries default, they could find themselves unable to borrow money from international capital market, international capital markets for years. So that's what they wanted. They can then start getting them to their knees. This year reach nations belonging to the so-called Group of 20 or G20 devised a debt service suspension initiative to help the world's poorest countries cope with the fallout of the COVID-19 crisis until the middle of next year. The DSSI offers a temporary suspension of official sector or government-to-government debt payment, and 43 countries have signed up so far. However, it does not cover private loans such as the euro bonds coming due for Zambia. It's always like, you know, oh yes, but you gotta read the fine print. In October, the China Development Bank agreed to schedule Zambia's interest payments until April 2021. Zambia owed the bank roughly $391 million at the end of last year, about a tenth of the $3 billion it owes Chinese entities. According to the finance ministry, I'm sorry, it was not clear enough to the loan in question covers all this debt or a fraction of it. You know, and I'm the one who didn't go to school. But communication, they make it so murky when they want to, you know. In 2018, China took possession of a valuable port in Sri Lanka and 15,000 acres when that country was unable to reschedule its debt. Zambia is one of the world's top copper producers. But foreign companies, own 80% of Zambia's annual copper production. Wow. It's like, in my home state, you know, we produce tequila, but we don't own shit. You know, if anything, they're taking all our water to make the damn tequila. Zambia is one of the world's top copper producers, but foreign companies own 80% of Zambia's annual copper production. They are MCM, which is 73.1% owned by the Anglo-Swiss multinational Glencore, First Quantum Minerals of Canada. Look, Canada, what do you got to do all the way there in Zambia? For real. Which owns 16.9%, and Zambia's mining investment arm, Z, as in Zebra, CCM-IH, owns 10%. Everybody, just, oh my God. They need to pass a law where they prohibiting all any kind of monopoly. Other countries that they want, maximum 10%. That's it. That's how you nationalize shit. It's like, we have a new law. And sometimes, you know, we find out, like in Mexico, now that we've been 2 years in office, you find out all these laws is already there. But they do whatever they want with the Constitution. Okay, the last one, I think. No, there was another one. I don't know if it's in the other one. I don't know. Trouble ahead if there's no Brexit deal in the next 10 days. Irish FM warns. Oh, this is not about Africa. They put it in the same page as Africa. I don't know why they... I think every paper should have at least a section on the African continent. Look, Spain opened second migrant camp on overrun Gran Canaria Island. They have them out in the open. They have them out in the open. Not even a roof. You know, talk about South America. Well, so-called South America. Peru's Congress appoints third president in 1 week. I'm not gonna read you that. I know, it's like, people, they get crazy with the hashtags. People, they get crazy with the hashtags and it's like, oh yes, we want him to put him in jail. Yeah, that's a good thing. But is it really feasible? I mean, like, when all the institutions belong to the European corporations? I think that was it. Anyway, it's getting too damn cold. I'm out of here. Have a lovely rest of the 2020. And if you're enjoying 2020, smoke some 420. Yes, I mean, come on. Enough with the satanization of the bud. I'm trying to put it back in. In love with you. Oh, my hand is cold. Touch it. Freezing. You see? Freezing. And it's not even that cold. It's freezing. I wonder if he's gonna come back. Is he gonna come back? You know, just they haven't fall off. Some of these leaves are very resilient. No, we don't wanna fall off yet. They're holding on for dear life. This one couldn't hold me. That poor little dude. I'm sorry. I'm live laughing at their nakedness. You know? No. I know it's... They look gorgeous still. Look at that. No leaves. You know, if you wanted to paint this, you would be like, it's so intricate little branches branching out. You just count the little branches coming out of each branch. You will be here all day. It's all about abundance. It's all about abundance. But somehow the crackers have made us believe it's like, oh no, there's scarcity, there's not enough, we're gonna die. And some freaking people, I don't know if it was to me or not, some freaking people, they believe it, they buy it. The scarcity scam. Later,